have learned that every sentence can be divided into two parts, subject and predicate. A ball rolls on the ground. Here, a ball is the subject, rolls on the ground is the predicate. So, what is the subject and the predicate? Well, subject tells us who or what is performing the verb. It can be a noun or a pronoun or a group of words acting as a noun. Whereas the predicate tells us about the subject and it always contains the verb. Now look at this sentence. The boy is my friend. So what is the verb in this case? Is. So who is my friend? It is the boy. So here the boy is the subject, is my friend is the predicate. Why have we included the in this case? Because this article the is modifying the noun boy. So whatever modifies the noun which is in the subject position has to be included within the subject. Now we must also note that any noun cannot be the subject of the sentence. Only the noun which performs the verb is the subject. So here friend is also a noun, but it is not the subject. Why? Because this verb is not performed by the noun friend. It is performed by the noun boy. And because the is modifying this particular noun, so the boy becomes the subject. Now in this case, the boy with brown hair is my friend. So what have we added in this case? With brown hair. So if I question who is my friend, what is the answer? The boy. Once again, this boy is my friend, but the difference is here we have some more information about the boy. What is it? The boy with brown hair. So it is not just any boy who is my friend, but the boy with brown hair is my friend. So the noun boy not only has this modifier in the form of an article, but also this particular part, a phrase with brown hair, which is describing the boy. So the boy with brown hair altogether becomes the subject of the sentence, whereas is my friend is the predicate. Now if I say the boy who is sitting at the corner is my friend, so here how do we find the subject? Well, first we need to find out the verb. So once again our verb is. Now you might be thinking that is sitting is also a verb. Why are we not considering this part? Well, if you see who is sitting at the corner. Now, we also have another verb is sitting in this sentence, but we are not considering that part. Why? Because is sitting has the subject who. So, who is sitting at the corner is actually describing the noun boy. It is not the complete sentence. Whereas is my friend, so is, this is our, actually the main verb of the sentence. Now if I ask who is my friend, the answer would be not just the boy, but the boy who is sitting at the corner. Why? Because this entire part, who is sitting at the corner, is also modifying the noun boy. So just the boy won't do. It is not just any boy, but the boy who is sitting at the corner. So this entire part becomes the subject. The boy who is sitting at the corner becomes the subject. Is my friend is the predicate. The members of the club donated money for social work. Now, what is the verb in this case? Donated. If I say who donated money for social work, it is the members of the club. Now you would think Why is it not just the members? Well, this is because this phrase of the club is actually describing the members. So, this of the club is a phrase that describes which members in specific we are talking about. So, not only the noun but the words which are modifying the noun in the subject is also included within the subject. So, who donated money for social work? It will neither be just the club donated money nor just the members who donated money. It's the members of the club who donated the money for social work. So, what is important to note here? You should note that the members of the club is becoming the subject. Now, in the subject, we have two nouns, but we have to be careful that this entire group of words is actually acting as a noun. So, we know from the definition of subject that the subject can have a group of words that acts like a noun. So, in this case, this entire group of words is actually acting like a noun. It is giving us the answer of who. So, this entire part becomes our subject. Also, we must remember that not just any noun can be the subject. Only the noun which is performing the verb becomes the subject. In this case, this entire part is performing the verb. Mainly, the members are donating. But which members? The members of the club. So, the entire part becomes the subject. The shop next to our house is closed today. So, here the verb is. So, if I question, what is closed today? What is the answer? The shop. But is it any shop? No. There's a specific shop which is being talked about. Which is it? The shop next to our house. So, if this is the house, this is the shop, this shop is closed. So, the shop next to our house, this entire part becomes the subject because next to our house is a part which is describing the shop. Which shop is closed? The shop next to our house is closed today. So, when we find out the subject, we not only pick out the noun but also include the other words or parts of the sentence which is modifying the noun, and this entire portion becomes our subject. The shop next to our house in totality becomes the subject. Is closed today is our predicate. Going for a morning walk every day is a good habit. So, here is the verb. Now, if I say what is a good habit? Is it every day is a good habit? Walk every day is a good habit? No. Going for a morning walk every day is a good habit. So, you see this entire part is the subject because this entire group of words is actually giving us the answer of what. So, it is actually acting as a noun. So, a subject definitely can be a group of words acting as a noun. Now, one thing we need to know that going, you know, is the ing form of the verb go. So, you might just think that going is a verb, but no, in this case going is not the verb, it is actually the participle. So, this is acting as a noun in this sentence and not as a verb. So, be careful not to get confused when you see words like this at the beginning. Some ing forms of verbs that you know can act as nouns and they are performing the work of a noun in this sentence and not the verb. So, what do we get as the subject? Going for a morning walk every day. And what is the predicate? Is a good habit. Whoever lies will be punished. Now here, what is the verb? Will be punished. This entire portion is the verb. So who will be punished? Whoever lies will be punished. So whoever lies actually is the subject. Now you will say that lies is a verb. So how is this part included in the subject? Well, when I say who, this entire part, whoever lies, is answering the question of who. So we know that whatever answers the question of who or what is actually a noun. So in this case, whoever lies is acting as a noun. So entire part, including lies, because whoever lies together gives us the answer of who. So this acts like a noun, and hence whoever lies becomes the subject, will be punished becomes the predicate. So this can be really confusing at times. You need to see, or you need to understand the logic behind why we are including this verb within the subject and this verb in the predicate. Now, you should also notice one thing. In all other examples that we have seen, the predicate included the verb and some other words apart from the verb. But in this case, the entire predicate simply consists of the verb and no other words. We know that the verb is an essential part of the predicate. So there can be cases where we will see that the predicate can have just the verb and there can be no other words, as in this case. We walked to a shop which was inside the station. Once again, what is the verb here? Walked. So don't get confused. This was, we are not considering. Why? Because this part, which was inside the station, this entire part is describing the noun shop. It is not the verb on which the sentence stands on. We walked to a shop makes a complete sense. So which was inside the station is an additional information about the shop. Therefore, we are not considering this verb. We are considering this verb. Now, if the question is, who walked to a shop? The answer is we. So what is our subject? We. And the remaining part, walked to a shop, which was inside the station, this entire part comes under the predicate. Now this part is describing a noun, shop, but this entire part comes under the predicate. Why? Because this noun shop is not our subject. It is actually telling us where we walk to. So this shop is a part of the predicate. So whatever part describes the shop will also be included within the predicate. So remember, any clauses or phrases which are modifying a noun in the predicate will also go to the predicate. If we have any phrases or clauses modifying or qualifying a noun in the subject position, only then the clauses or phrases are included within the subject. Divide the sentence into subject and predicate. Being the team captain is a huge responsibility. So here, can you divide the sentence and find out the subject and the predicate? Well, what is the first thing that we need to do? Identify the verb. So what is the verb here? Is. What is a huge responsibility? Being the team captain. Not captain is a huge responsibility. No, team captain is a huge responsibility. Even that is not the correct thing. So being the team captain, this entire thing is a huge responsibility. So being the team captain, this entire part is giving us the answer to the question, what. That means this particular group of words is acting as a noun in this case. Also note, this word being may look like a verb, but here in this case it's not the verb, it is acting as a noun. So don't get confused, this is not a verb in this sentence, the verb is. So what will be our subject and predicate? Being the team captain, this entire part comes under the subject, is a huge responsibility, that is the rest of the sentence becomes the predicate. So what did we learn today? Today we learned how to divide sentences into subject and predicate. Often we have very complex subjects, as in subjects which have clauses and phrases involved in them. So at times they can get really tricky. So we need to understand which part is actually describing the noun in the subject. We know that the subject can be a noun or a pronoun or a group of words acting as a noun. In case it is a noun, we have to be careful and we must always include the article or any other groups of words which are modifying that noun. Now, not any noun can be the subject, only the noun which performs the verb in a sentence can be the subject. So all you need to do is take up more examples and see if you can find out the correct subject and predicate in a sentence. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. You can also register for free at deltastep.com or download the DeltaStep app to get all learning resources as per ICSE, CBSE, IB, Cambridge or any other curriculum. Over 5,000 amazing lectures across Maths, Science, English and Social Science. Our unique interactive video technology keeps you engaged and our iDictionary feature allows you to quickly revise any concept. Master each topic at your own pace with our adaptive practice technology and 1 million plus questions. Get instant answers and detailed solutions. Be exam ready by taking unlimited mock tests, performance analysis along with actionable feedback, personal tutors to resolve your slightest of doubts. That's not all. You can also win amazing prizes like PlayStation, iPad, watches and many more along with certificates through our Earn As You Learn program. So at DeltaStep, learning is not just fun and easy, it is rewarding too. So register for free now.